As everybody knows, a fishing day is never complete without a cup of tea. But not just any cup of tea, you've got to make it on the bank to really get the essence of tea. And to make it on the bank, don't use a gas stove or a petrol stove or anything like that. Kelly kettle. I've put in 2 pints of water in that spout. The smoke comes up there, so you've got a sort of like a water jacket around it. And this was given to me by Dave Swallow the week before I left for Redmire to start Passion for Angling. He thought it would come in handy. And now it's 22 years later and I use it virtually every time I go fishing. This is the 3-man or 4-man cup Kelly, but I've also got a smaller one, which is a 1-pint Kelly, where I use on my own or if I'm just fishing with a mate. But anyway, so I've got 2 pints of water in there. I use a little bit of paper, but you know, a bit of dry nettle or whatever. Just get that started. And the great thing about a Kelly kettle is it's so fast. I defy anybody to boil 2 pints of water faster than a Kelly kettle. I know I had a race with Hugh Miles when we were doing Passion for Angling, because as a wildlife photographer, he was pretty big on camping gear, cooking gear, and he had a high-tech one, and we had a race, and the Kelly beat him by, I should think, about half. It achieved a boiling of two pints in half the time of his very high-tech African safari kettle, and which, of course, was gas. So just feed it with, this is last year's nettle and hogweed, get a bit of flame, you know, Don't overdo it to start with. Just let those flames start trickling up. Gradually keep feeding, and then you've got some bigger stuff once it's really going. And when it's, you know, even when it's raining, pouring with rain, you can hear already we've got, it's beginning to go. And this is really dry. It hasn't rained for weeks, and we've got, plenty of dry kindling, but if it's been raining, you know, always have a little bit in supply at home. Keep it in a wrap it up in a bag. Are you still there? Where am I? And that way you can just, or even a newspaper, you know, copy the Angling Times, works perfectly. I think we're going to get to that wonderful moment in a minute when the whole thing starts to vibrate. Feed, keep feeding. It burns very fast with this fine stuff. But the hissing has gone soft now, and you know when that hissing suddenly, it's like a, you know, like an electric kettle, it makes a lot of noise to start with, and just before the boiling, you get that lovely silence, and you know it's nearly time for tea. And here we go. We have the, we're getting towards explosion time. So before that blows up, because this is the greatest steam engine after Stevenson's rocket, and I've got a proper teapot. I should have put the tea in first. 1, 2, 3, and one for the pot. And then up she comes. The chain, which should be on the back for pouring, has gone a long time ago, but I've still got this little, see, it's cool. It doesn't burn my hands, and it's very neat. You just in she goes. That's about just over three good cups, because I'll need another one. So it's 4 cups there, and leave that to brew. We've got proper tea, no tea bags here, and that's it. Tea ready, and the next shot you'll see will be a very satisfied angler with the moment he's been waiting for all day. Forget the fish. What you need is a really good cup of tea. Now, before the tea is quite brewed, milk goes in first. We don't do it the way the royal family does it. The royal family are stupid. They don't know how to make a cup of tea. Milk goes in first. And actually, I like soy milk, unsweetened soy milk, but other people might complain here. So we're having proper dairy milk, cow's milk, and never neglect nature's refrigerator. We've got the milk in the margins, keeping cool, because it's a hot day today. So always keep your milk at a reasonable temperature, not beyond 50, 52 degrees today. maybe that's an underestimation. I would say 65 degrees today, but it's still cooler there than it is out here. So a little splash of milk, not too much. Just throw that away. And their pièce de résistance, the tea. Oh, good colour. This is Miles Ceylon blend, not Hugh Miles. This is an even greater Miles, Miles the tea importers. They do import a good blend. And there we have it. And I will have this one because it's, as you can see, I haven't washed it since yesterday. You get a nice, you get the wood smoke, you get that effect. And cheers. Here's to everyone who can appreciate a really good cup of tea. Oh my God, I have no words. Tea up!